In Beck's segment tonight, as you may know, the state of Colorado has legalized marijuana. Now, the largest newspaper there, the Denver Post, has actually hired an editor to promote pot. Think about this. The only reason you use weed outside of a medical situation is to intoxicate yourself. And of course, that can lead to bad things. DUI, the use of harder drugs. The new marijuana editor recently appeared on TV.
Are you high right now?
I am definitely not high.
Are you sure? So you're not high now, but do you smoke pot at all?
I don't smoke pot. I do eat it, though.
Oh, okay. Oh.
But it's really, is this a laughing matter? Really? Joining us now from Washington, Mary Catherine Hamm, and here in the studio, Juan Williams, both are Fox News analysts. You know, this bothers me. I don't think that they should hire. The Denver Post, when I worked in Denver a long time ago, was a good newspaper. Now it's a very far-left concern. And they're promoting marijuana use. I just don't think it's good.
Are they promoting wine use and restaurants when they review restaurants?
Well, restaurants, that's not an intoxication deal, is it?
No.
When you go
to
a restaurant, do you get drunk?
No.
Do you?
Oh, I drink alcohol at restaurants.
And you get loaded?
Not, come on.
Do you get loaded?
No, I do not.
So what's the analogy with the restaurant?
Well, because you're doing wine and restaurant reviews. These are people who have, consumers, have an interest in the product. Marijuana is legal in Colorado, so yeah. There is a business there, and people who like the product will want to read reviews.
So shouldn't they hire a booze columnist, editor, to say, look, this is the best way to get high. Here we can drink Baileys,
no.
Or we can drink gin, and here's how you mix
person.
It.
You are a harsh person.
I'm not a harsh
man.
Person.
You
There's
are.
Only one reason, Mary Catherine, as I pointed out, to use marijuana. That's to get high. Am I wrong?
Right. Well, I think you're right. First of all, I volunteer to be the booze analyst in Denver. Second of all, I'm very good. Second of all, no, I don't think this is just about being a critic. This isn't being covered from a sort of consumerist connoisseur point of view. If they wanted that, they could have hired Smokey or Big Worm to do it. But they hired a guy who's a newspaper veteran, and this is a newsworthy beat. I think another part of it is that they think, well, if we cover marijuana pretty closely and it is a news story, it'll probably earn us some buzz, and that literally was not an intended pun, but you can't get through one of these segments without doing that. And so I think they were looking for some readership as well. But this is a serious public policy issue from
Absolutely.
Your point of view,
and they're
Bill,
hiring
and
a critic who's going to have to ingest marijuana and tell everybody what's the best,
I think,
you know,
that might
intoxicant
be part of it, but
use.
I'm not sure that's going to be the whole ballgame.
Why don't we have a heroin or a methadone? No, methadone's legal. Let's
that
do a
one I'm not in for.
How about methadone? Why don't we have a methadone critic to say, look, this is the best methadone. It's legal. And why don't we have that?
We do have health sections.
And health sections.
Yeah, we have health sections.
This is like the restaurant analogy. What?
No,
this is weak.
This is not
this
weak.
Is weak.
Let me tell you something.
It really is.
No, if you have a health section, they talk about people with addictions. Methadone is give something
That's
given
not
to
what
the
this
addicts.
Is about. This is about promoting it.
This is not about promoting it.
It's telling you
it's
legal. What? It's absolutely promoting it.
It is not.
Sure it is.
Hold
you
on.
Got the guy on TV, national TV, going, I eat it. And
right.
I was like,
look,
what
that
are
was,
look,
that
what?
Was, look, that
you got teenagers. If you have teenagers, you want them to read where the best pot is in the state.
You know what? What do you think about alcohol? Alcohol.
I just said that. Do you want a booze guy to show you how to get?
I'm telling you, every day in the newspaper, my family gets the New York Times, Washington Post, Wall Street Journal. There are reviews of wine.
It's not about that. You know, you can drink wine without getting inebriated. Go.
As this progresses, the fight is not over with the legalization in Colorado. As it progresses in community after community, they're going to decide what can be in a retail store, how they're going to do that, where they can put stores, how strong the weed is in any given area. There's going to be all these decisions that have to be made that are public policy decisions. You want that to be covered.
No,
as
this
a guy
is what's
going to
happen in the Denver Post. They're going to tell you what the best bud is. I feel like Spicoli.
It sounds like it's much more than
that.
They
tell
to
you
me.
What the best bud is, where to buy it, how to prune it. How to roll it. This is promoting the use of an intoxicant by the Denver Post. Why don't you just set it up like, here's the bar in Denver where you can get the cheapest chasers and the most gin for your money. This is exactly what it is, Mary Catherine.
I disagree with you. I think it's a public policy issue that's going to be covered mostly like
you
a public policy issue.
You can cover the policy without getting a critic who has to ingest the substance,
okay,
Mary Catherine.
That part is fair. If part of the job is ingesting the substance, you don't have to have that part.
And
but
then
I think
they
that,
go
I think
on.
That a person who does ingest it can easily report on it as a public policy issue.
Here's how absurd this is, Williams.
Yes.
Then the Denver Post sends a memo to its employees saying, even though we have a marijuana critic, and we're going to tell you where to get the best bud. You can't use it on the premises of the Denver Post.
Well,
I mean,
not.
Come on.
What?
Well, why do you have it in
now,
it anyway?
They should light
Wait
up
a minute.
Everywhere.
You can't smoke. You can't even smoke a cigarette in this building.
Who's promoting tobacco?
Well, no, what are you talking about? We don't take ads for tobacco.
No, we don't.
The newspapers that we.
I don't. We don't run the newspapers.
Oh, okay, but that's part of our corporation. But I'm just saying, you know that all these products are now, and it's legal. Let me emphasize that legal.
Yes. Yeah.
And the cops do not have to go
You're
out and
promoting
chase
intoxication
and arrest some kid.
Right.
It is not. You are being.
Well,
let me say,
yeah,
it's rare that Mary Catherine and I would say to Bill O'Reilly, Bill, you're getting lost here.
Uh-huh.
You're
well,
in the
we
weeds
might both
on
be
this
high,
one.
Juan. Who knows?
All right. Here's the deal. Here's the deal. The Denver Post is promoting intoxication, which is going to lead to more DUIs, as we've seen in Washington
well,
State.
Well, that's a problem.
Okay. And that's what they're
well,
doing.
Well, I agree with you.
Bottom line.
The kids should not be able to use it, and
that's
certainly
right.
it should
Nobody
be
should be able to buy the Denver Post until you're 21.
And then
well,
you
that might be one of the stories
it.
Covered when you have somebody right. covering this beat, and I think you would appreciate that.
Oh, yeah. Well, they're giving a free subscription to Cheech and Chong.